Good morning, goddammit. Piss and vinegar day 80, no, 92. Back in Rear Delts, I discovered a really cool way of doing pullovers today that makes it very much akin or is very reminiscent of the Nautilus pullover machine for the lats that like Dorian Yates and Mike Mensa would use with the cable stack today, but my fucking phone or the recording cut out because it overheated, so you didn't get to see it. It's a teaser for next week. Tune in for next week's back day, and you'll get to see this really cool way of training my lats with pullovers with the cables. Anyway, today's topic, I was in the process of editing this video. I was looking at my outfit and went, "My God, I look fucking goofy." But a thought came to my head, and it's something I was talking to someone about the other day, where I was thinking, and this is something I've thought about for years, where people overcompensate with their clothing for their lack of physique. Now, in this case, this outfit is so brutally goofy and so shitty. Like, I'm wearing Crocs with fucking genie pants and a cheap circuit shirt. But it really sparked this idea that people overcompensate with their clothing. If you don't have a great physique, if you're not lean and muscular, whether you're a man or a woman, and you're wearing really nice clothing, it's to overcompensate for a shitty physique. It's more impressive when you see someone with a great physique in average clothing than when you see a morbidly obese person in the nicest Gucci shirt or Lizzo wearing a fucking $10,000 dress and a bunch of makeup. She still looks like a hot mess and looks gross. Whereas some average chick who's working at a fucking, I don't know, convenience store, who's wearing no makeup and like the shittiest convenience store clothing, who just doesn't overeat, looks tremendously better than Lizzo. Same thing with the men. The man who lifts weights and doesn't eat, overeat and has a good physique, who wears just, standard clothing from Target, looks tremendously better than the obese guy who walks around with the most expensive clothing. It's an overcompensation. And I don't understand this mentality of like, if you're, I just don't understand why fat people or out of shape people spend money on nice clothes. It's like a waste of money. It's like, what are you doing? Like, you look like shit, so what's the point? Like, it's false confidence, and it's a waste of money because you don't look good anyway. You've ruined these nice clothes. Now, obviously, if you're in great shape and then you want to buy nice clothes, more power to you. It's only the icing on the cake at that point. But it's honestly like when you're in a good shape, you don't really need the nicest clothes. People will respect you and find you far more attractive and overlook the fact that you're not wearing fucking expensive clothing if you have a great physique. So that's kind of what I was thinking about today when I was looking at this outfit. This outfit is irredeemable, regardless of how nice my physique is. I'd have to look a hell of a lot better than I do right now to pull this. Maybe, I don't know, maybe someone would think this is cool. Maybe it's like an MC Hammer vibe, but anyway, the point is, if you're wearing nice clothes to overcompensate for the fact that you're fat or not muscular, you're deluding yourself. And it's actually kind of cool when you see someone who's wearing almost cheap, daggy clothing, but they pull it off because they have such an exceptional physique. Like when you see a guy who's just wearing track pants and a sweater, but they're jacked and they have a lean, handsome face. Sounds gay, but like this guy, it's like, wow, who gives a fuck? You're allowed to wear that because you look like that. You put the effort in, you don't really need the expensive clothes anymore. It'd only be icing on the cake. Or the chick who does heavy squats and doesn't eat too much, who just wears the same sort of thing, like a sweater and a fucking daggy, pair of trackies. It's like, what do I care if she has nice clothing on? Like that, as a fucking dude that likes attractive women, I would just be like, who cares? Like, that doesn't matter. So, yeah, that's just kind of where I'm at today. Thinking about this fucking outfit I'm wearing is don't overcompensate with nice clothes for a shitty physique. And this ties into many other aspects. Like, people will often respect the guy who has a great physique over the guy who's wearing the nice Rolex and driving the BMW. You combine the two, and now you're like, that extra echelon above. But a good physique and a healthy physique and a lean aesthetic face goes a lot longer than a long way. It goes further than most other aspects. If not, it goes the furthest. There are many studies that show taller, thinner, more muscular people, women, men. I mean, men and women have slightly different beauty requirements. You know, men should be a bit more muscular and tanned. Women are typically thought of to be a bit more lean and pale. But basically, the general beauty standards, of which two things that go into that is being lean and muscular, are typically more respected than anything else. Obviously, the height thing you can't really change, but the training and musculature will change a lot. And then that will go to your inner social dynamics. Like, if you're hanging out with blokes, you're hanging out with men, and you're muscular and strong and, you know, potentially more muscular and strong than everybody else. And this sounds very insecure, but it's just a matter of fact, is if you're bigger and stronger than all the men that you're just currently talking to, you're going to be far more confident than if they were all bigger and stronger than you. That's a fact. You might still be very confident as a person, but you'll be more confident when you're physically capable and you're essentially what incels say, mogging people. So it will help in so many other ways other than the fact that you won't have to wear nice clothes. It's like the ultimate compensation for every other potential downfall that you have as a person, physically or mentally or socially, is being in great shape. It will carry you a very long way. And then, by proxy of being in better shape and looking better, you'll have more confidence, which will allow you to do better in the workforce or in your business, or making business deals and having respect or chasing women or any of these things that, you know, make men typically happy. These things will come by proxy of building the confidence and the work ethic from training heavy weights and eating a clean diet. So compensate with the physique first, and then let everything else fall in line later. Don't buy the nice clothes. Don't buy the BMW first. Just get a good physique. Get a good physique. Be lean enough that your face isn't a fat fucking hot mess. And life will be a lot easier. I mean, I'll probably get a lot of hate from incels who are like, yeah, but I'm 5'5", so chicks won't give me the fucking night of day because, you know, I'm muscular, but I'm too short. Or my canthal tilt, or whatever their facial measurement schizoid fucking things they go into, where it's like, my face isn't handsome enough no matter how good my body gets. Yeah, it sucks, and you know, some people are taller and more handsome than others, but you can only work with what you've got. You can only be as handsome as you can potentially be, and at the end of the day, most men can get pretty muscular, pretty handsome and lean. And some of us may be more than others, obviously some of us more than others, but you can only be the best version of yourself, and one of the easiest ways of being the best version of yourself, or being on path to that, is getting your physique and body fat percentage in line first. So, kind of off a tangent from the clothing, but it ties in. Get the physique, get the body, get the mind, the face, and the mind by proxy in order first. And then you can get cool clothes. I mean, I've got nothing against clothing, and by the same token, you don't want to be this fucking, like, jacked, like, weirdo who doesn't shower or wear nice clothing, because all the muscles in the world won't matter if you're wearing what I'm wearing today in my workout, and you smell like shit because you haven't showered in 4 days. Like, of course. And then don't be some weird fucking, like, social retard and, you know, I don't know, like, saying weird things in public to people, or saying weird politically incorrect things to people that you shouldn't be saying to, or whatever it is. Like, obviously have some social skills, develop those, and shower and wear something that's at least, you know, not stained, or make sure your clothes are, like, clean and fucking presentable and not, like, massively mismatching like my clothes are today. But, like, on average, if everything else in your life is average, your income's average, your clothing's average, your social skills are average, but then your physique is exceptional, that will carry you massively. And then you can work on all those other things, like your speaking abilities, your social abilities, your clothing, your finances. If you're really short, I mean, you can put fucking lifts in your shoes or something. I don't know what to tell you. Like, there are some things that you just will not be able to change. But even then, you can probably change them pretty to a certain degree. If you're really short, you can put lifts in your shoes. I mean, whatever it is. There's so many different things that are potentially out of your hands, but you can do little things to potentially improve them. In my case, I have really wide hips, so certain pants or clothing combinations will make my hips look really fucking big. I have really small hands. There's just not much I can do about that, But what I can do about them is make them really thick and muscular and meaty, so at least they look masculine. Because I had short hands, short fingers at least, and skinny hands. You know, a few years ago, 6-7 years ago, I had these short fingers that were skinny, and it looked super feminine and just, like, not very attractive. Nowadays, my hands are still short because, it's, again, there's nothing I can do about it, but they're really thick and veiny and tough from doing arm wrestling training. So even in areas that you are massively lacking, you can potentially increase them. This fucking video has been all over the place. It's almost like a weird self-help fucking red pill talk. But basically, if you're a fat piece of shit, don't buy nice clothes. Buy them when you've lost the weight and got a good physique. Bye-bye.